Hey everybody, my name is Melissa, and this is a story from 10 years ago. So, my dad gets this phone call one day, and it sounds like this. Hi, Mr. Markowitz, this is the Deerfield Beach Police Department, and we found your daughter's purse, and we found her severed finger in the purse. So, as you can see, I do have all 10 of my fingers, so here we go. So, growing up, I was a prankster. I thought, well, this is the best way to get attention, and who doesn't love attention as a kid? And I felt like playing pranks was the most connective way to get people to let their guards down. Whether they were mad, sad, glad, scared, didn't matter, it was real. And kids like real stuff, you know? Not that fake Santa Claus stuff, and adults like real stuff too. So, my pranks progressed from simple magic shop trick stuff to pretending to put fake poop on my teacher's chairs in fourth grade to pretending to break my arm during the week that an international evangelist was coming to visit my high school. So, finally, I discovered special effects makeup, and I felt the potential to become the best prankster. I thought, what better way to get people's attention than pretend like you're dying? Or you're gushing blood. So, eventually, I learned how to use special effects makeup materials, because at the time, I wanted to be an FX artist. So, among many things, I made an exact replica of my index finger from silicone that I got on a trip to LA with my mom to check out studios and supply shops. So I bought silicone, came back home, made a negative mold on my finger, then a positive, then a negative, and then a positive with the silicone with the flocking, which is fiberglass specs. It looks like blood capillaries, so hold your finger up. And like, just look at the cracks and the colors. This is that real. So I was like, I gotta have some fun with this. So my favorite thing to do was to take this with me out to eat with my family. Like, buried under some fries, my spaghetti, it didn't matter because they were my favorite culprits because I got joy from embarrassing them. So about 6 months later, they were like, okay, knock it off. We're not taking you out to eat anymore, please. So I accepted this and I put the finger in a pill jar that had my name on it in my purse. And I forgot about it. I just left it in there unless I was on a bad date or something. So, it's like shits and giggles galore if you're on a bad day. You just take it out. And you're like, whoop. So, a couple months later, I go to this event at the Hilton to sell crafts, and I'm one of the vendors. And later on that night, I go out to eat with people I thought were trustworthy. I put my purse on the back of the chair, and I say, wash my stuff. I'm going to the bathroom. I come back. My purse is gone. I asked these little fuckers who saw my purse, where to go. Everyone said they had no idea what happened. So at this point, I'm just worrying about my ID, my keys. I totally forgot the finger existed. So I got a ride home a couple hours later, and I walk outside the hotel to get my ride. And I see shit scattered all over the parking lot. I walk up to that shit, I look down, I go, wow, that's my shit. So, I'm thinking, not at the moment, but whoever found my purse said, holy shit, there's a finger in here. What crazy bitch has a finger in her purse? I'm gonna throw this stuff all over the parking lot, wipe my fingerprints off, because I don't want to be involved in a murder case. So, meanwhile, I'm at the gym, because that's where my ride dropped me off. I had about 10 unlisted numbers call me, but I didn't pick them up because it was unlisted, and it was the police who had found my stuff trying to see if I was alive. So, meanwhile, they dispatched 2 agents over to my parents' house to tell them of this tragic news that Melissa might be dead. So, that was when my dad got that call, and his response to that call was just, oh, the finger. So, later on that night, I get home. My dad tells me the whole story. He says, okay, here's the story. The police already know it's a joke because they sent the finger off to the forensics lab. And they cut it in half. So I head down to the station. I'm greeted by two officers. They hand me my finger now in half. We have a little giggle. And I realize this was the day I was caught. Because the whole time I was pranking everybody else, now it was me. And my little security blanket was gone. And I realized to be caught in life is actually a privilege because it's real and it's true. And I realized that I don't need tricks or toys to connect with people because I have myself.